David was a tremendous worshiper. He was somebody who put worship as a priority in his life from his youth. Worship was a priority. Ask your neighbor, is worship a priority in your life? David was an absolute worshiper. He was totally in love with God. He wrote many of the Psalms. He was constantly worshiping God, constantly giving Him glory, constantly giving Him honor. You know, you can read through his whole life making extravagant sacrifices unto the Lord, even before his death, making extravagant preparation for the building of the temple. David was a worshiper, an extravagant, exuberant, wholehearted worshiper. Somehow, David understood that God's presence was to be the center of Israel's attention. And so this was kind of part of the point that I was trying to point out a couple of weeks ago, that we are so often, we are seeking the hand of God, we are seeking the blessing of God, we are seeking answers to prayer, when if we would seek the face of God, if we would seek the presence of the Lord, all the blessings would be poured out. There would be no need to seek His blessing. If you will seek His face and put His presence as the center and priority of your life, God will open the windows of heaven and pour out so much blessing, you can't contain it. We have got to become a people who put God's presence as number one priority in our lives, in our church, in our home, in our business, in our marriages. We have to become a people who are hungry and thirsty for the manifest presence of God in our lives on a daily basis. If we'll put God's presence first, there'll be no lack. There'll be no hindrance to prayer if we'll put His presence first and foremost.